following is a special presentation of WEDU Tampa, St. Petersburg, Sarasota.
Let's enjoy some of the purest of all music. Look into seashells and the people who collect them. Go to work with the Pepper Patrol and revisit an old friend with an old challenge on this volume of a Gulf Coast Journal.
This WEDU production is exclusively brought to you through a generous grant from the Gulf Coast Community Foundation of Venice, building strong communities, leadership, partnership, and endowed philanthropy.
Dear Journal, aside from the surf, is there any music so pure, so almost angelic, as the music of an acoustic guitar? Along the Gulf Coast, there are many appreciators of that pure music, and more splendid opportunities to enjoy it. How different it is to hear the sweet sound of the acoustic guitar in a church. This is Sarasota's St. Paul's Lutheran, rather than an electric guitar in a bar. In the hands of musician Jason Vio, it seems as though Bach had written his fugue specifically for this instrument.
If you want to really listen to classical music, you have to come to a place where it's quiet and people have to listen, and it's not in a bar where you can't experience that.
I'm playing a prelude by Francisco Tárrega.
A professional guitarist himself, Thomas Koch, is the guitar's best advocate.
The instrument has an ambiguity because it's so popular in both pop and classical music genres. The training of classical guitarists has come a long way, and we are now having such great players on a large level.
To celebrate those great players, Koch started Guitar Sarasota, a society for guitar enthusiasts like himself.
We got together, a bunch of friends, and decided that we needed something like Guitar Sarasota in town.
The idea was put into motion, word spread. Koch soon found others shared his admiration.
We have students, we have young people, we have retired people, guitar makers, we have guitar collectors, we have the amateur that wants to perform in front of a small group of people.
The guitar has not always been accepted as standard classical fare. It was Spanish guitarist Andres Segovia who brought life to the classical guitar, turning compositions intended for other instruments into masterpieces that sounded tailor-made for guitar.
I think that the instrument has still a little bit of catching up to do, even though there has been a lot of progress made over the last 50 years.
By forming Guitar Sarasota, Thomas and society members share the virtues of classical guitar with future performers, eager listeners, and each other.
I didn't dream of this growth and interest in GuitarSarasota a year ago. We had nothing about a year ago, and we have created an audience, a faithful audience that comes back for the concerts.
Attracting talented guitarists like Vio shows how well-respected this fledgling society has become.
With the guitar community, you get a more intimate audience that you wouldn't get from, say, playing with a symphony.
As impressive as his flawless performance is Jason's ability to have memorized hundreds of pieces in his repertoire.
I guess the memory card holds about maybe 4 or 5 hours, and maybe more. I'm not really sure. At a time, I don't know how much my memory card holds before it's full.
Tapping into the hard drives of experienced guitarists through master classes is yet another aspect of this guitar society. Seventeen-year-old Andrew Glasgow was inspired and perhaps a little intimidated by the experience.
Everything in here is melody. That's the crazy thing about it, is that everything, when you get to hear...
Playing in someone, in front of someone like Jason is just amazing and just kind of like awestruck, I guess. And so... My playing definitely reflected my nervousness, for sure, but his advice was really greatly appreciated.
That was even better. That was even better.
Now that one big part of our mission is to educate, and we, I think, accomplished that with the concerts and even more with the master classes that take place.
The number of members is growing, concert crowds are ever larger. I guess Guitar Sarasota's efforts aren't falling on deaf ears.